crooked cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling. I will ever be true. Its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. And I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it some for a crown. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a
We gather here today to celebrate the gift of life and to recognize God as the generous giver of all life. We are especially grateful for the life of Alice Marie Rainey Oliver and all the ways she enriched this world while she was in it. We come here today to find comfort in our grief, to give our sorrows to God who can dry every tear, to love and support one another, and to find hope that death does not get the final say. We remember the words of the Apostle Paul as he wrote to the church in Thessalonica. We do not grieve as others do, those who have no hope. For we have hope in things yet unseen, and that is that life continues with God our Maker, who is our beginning and our end, and our home forevermore. Let us pray. Immortal, invisible, God only wise, you bring us life and you comfort us in death. Hear the words that are spoken here today and bless them to help those who are afflicted with pain and sorrow. Help us heal from our grief as we call upon your name and we lean upon each other for assistance. Bring us closer to your light as we hear about Alice's life. Remind us all of her goodness, her love, and the many good times that we had with her while she was here on earth. Kindle in our hearts a zeal for life and inspire us to live it fully as long as we shall have the breath of life within us. Mostly, O God, let us regard you as our Maker, our giver of life, the one to whom we owe everything. And may we continue in your image as we grow in the likeness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Alice Marie Rainey Oliver, 76, was the widow of Larry Joe Oliver. She died February 19th, 2024, at her home in North Middletown, Kentucky. She was born in North Middletown, Kentucky, to the late Clyde Thomas Rainey Sr. and the late Geneva Mae Smith Rainey. She was a retired Hensley Smith Mills employee and also worked at Walmart in Paris. Alice was a member of the North Middletown Christian Church. She loved fishing and shopping. She is survived by one daughter, Tessie Abner, two grandchildren, Tabitha and David Abner, one great-grandchild, Haley Abner, one sister, Kay Webb, and her husband, Larry, sister-in-law, Peggy Garrison. She is survived by several nieces, nephews, and cousins, including Tanya Dale and her husband, Eric, Brad Ballinger and his wife, Nikki, and Kimberly Little and her partner, Ty Foster. In addition to her husbands and parents, she was predeceased in death by one son, Jimmy Joe Oliver, one sister, Joyce Ballinger, one brother, Clyde Rainey Jr., a brother-in-law, Jimmy Garrison, a brother-in-law, Ronnie Bell, a sister-in-law, Barbara Bell, nephew, Bradley Curran, and grandparents, Clarence and Blanche Rainey. The pallbearers today will be Eric Dale, Brad Ballinger, Melvin Wolfenbarger, Tommy Humphreys, Ty Foster, Jason Wolfenbarger, and Lee Wolfenbarger. Let us now continue in our remembrances with another song that was special to Alice.
Precious memories, unseen angels, sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me, and the sacred past unfolds. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. Precious Father and loving Mother, fly across the lonely years, and old home scenes of my childhood in fond memory appear. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. I remember Mother praying, Father too, on bended knee. The sun is sinking, shadows falling, but their prayers still follow me. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred sayings unfold. Precious memories fill my soul.
The people of God are comforted by ancient words from Scripture. Hear now Jesus' words to his disciples as he was preparing them to understand that he must go forth with his mission, which included dying. From John 14, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, but also believe in me. For in my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also." And also our Lord's words from Matthew chapter 11. "Come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." Alice was born, raised, and educated in North Middletown, Kentucky. She lived on a farm with her family. She was the oldest of four siblings, including Clyde Thomas, Joyce Ballinger, and Kay Webb. She met her late husband, Larry Joe, in 1965, the same year she graduated from North Middletown High School. They met at her place of employment, the movie theater in Paris. They had a good life together, one that brought forth their daughter, Tessie. Alice worked at Hensley Mills, Walmart, and was a member of the North Middletown Christian Church. As you heard in her obituary, she enjoyed fishing. She also enjoyed camping. She and Larry Joe had a bass boat, which they put to good use on Old Stoner, putting it at the Fryman's Boat Dock. Her family has many fond memories of fishing at Lake Carnico, where she, Larry Joe, Kay, and Larry Webb would spend the day at the lake fishing and picnicking. Often they stayed past dark, casting their reels in one last time just to see if anything would bite. Once she and Larry Joe had a swan befriend them on the lake. That thing followed them around and then assertively followed them around and even boldly tried to board the vessel, following the smell of fish with the hope of food. The extended family enjoyed large camping trips at Boonesboro with the Rainy grandparents in the camper and all the rest tent camping around them. There were several close calls on various camping trips with heavy rain and rising waters, causing them to get up quickly in the middle of the night, toss everything into the trucks to head for higher ground, which is even more concerning because they did not know how to swim. She was no stranger to work. The entire family pitched in when it was time to set, pick, house, and strip tobacco on the Sparks farm. She harvested walnuts with the little ones going up into the trees, shaking the branches. They even did this on farms where they had to dodge the bulls. She was independent and she mowed her lawn up until the end, not only because she was fiercely independent, but because nobody else could do it right. The family recalls enjoying gatherings around the holidays. Christmas, as I understand, were a very big deal for the Rainey family. Tanya recalls meeting at her grandparents' house for a big meal, a night of playing bingo, and a big gift exchange after midnight. Alice hosted Easter. The cousins all dyed eggs, and then the adults hid them on the property where she enjoyed her plants and flowers. And 4th of July was a big deal at Kay's and Larry's. She had a big goldfish pond that she loved very much. After all the goldfish died, she still loved it because the frogs had taken over. And she would sit out there and enjoy watching the frogs hop and frolic, which I find very ironic because she also enjoyed frog legs. Alice and her sisters made an annual pilgrimage to Gatlinburg, Tennessee for many years together. You know, the perennial question is, where do you want to eat for dinner? I don't know. Where do you want to eat? I don't know. Where do you want to eat? And so what they would do when they got there is put all the restaurants that they wanted to go to on slips of paper, and then they would draw them out one per night so that they wouldn't have to make any decisions. Then they would play 21 with nickels after dinner into the late hours. She loved shopping, and she loved going to the aquarium. Kay and Alice would go shopping and enjoy lunch together in their retirement days. Kay was instructed to keep a list of who had paid for lunch so that they could continue the practice of alternating who paid each and every time, but Alice had trouble keeping up with that. I guess those who know her well know that she loved Crocs. Not the earthenware jars, which I thought when they told me, and not the animals, which was my second guess, but the shoes. She had numerous pairs, and they are still finding more. She had all the accessories that went with them, the little jewels that you could put in the holes. She had the fur liners for winter, so she could wear them all year long. She matched everything, including her hair accessories, to her Crocs. The company will notice she is gone because the orders of Crocs in Bourbon County will decrease sharply. She loved the music of Keith Urban, and she was upset that he had chosen Nicole Kidman over her. She also loved the music of Brad Paisley. She was lovingly called Ree, I understand, and Tootie by those who loved her. As I mentioned, Alice was independent, and as she got older, she became fiercely independent. She didn't let anyone help her with anything, and after Larry Joe died, she increasingly kept to herself, even though Kay and Larry were next door and invited her over. She spent the evenings mostly at home alone watching TV, and so some of you know that Alice had some health concerns. She had to watch her glucose, blood pressure, heart, and lungs. You might know that she had had a few masses on her lungs, and she had recently had some tumors discovered in her skull, one of which was recently removed. She suffered with emphysema, COPD, and ventricular aneurysm. She kept some of her medical diagnoses to herself because, once again, she was private and independent. But she saw what had happened to Larry Joe a few years ago when he was ill, and she made a decision not to suffer and not to burden anyone else with her care, and she told Kay that she was ready to be reunited with Larry. It's distressing for us to think about her making that decision to go ahead and be with the Lord, yet she didn't want to suffer anymore. She was already in a significant amount of pain. Mostly she kept that to herself. But she knew she was facing significant health challenges that likely would have led to her death in a short amount of time. And so she wanted to make that decision, and she wanted to have dignity with her dying. There was nothing anyone else could do to change her mind, so I don't want any of you to leave here feeling discouraged or guilty. She used her free will to make a decision, and she never, ever intended to hurt anyone else with it. And so it's important as we celebrate lives that we never ever let death overshadow the beautiful life. She lived on this earth for 76 years and was gone in a moment. And so her life is so very much more important than her death. And so all we can do today is honor her, to celebrate the gifts that she brought to the world, and to remember her fondly. The song we just listened to was about precious memories overwhelming our soul and how beautiful they can be. So I want you from this day forward to remember Alice fondly, how beautiful she was, how much she loved life, and how much she loved each and every one of you. We can share that light and that love with the world. And as long as we remember her, she is still here with us. So back to Brad Paisley, which she had a thing for. Here are words to his song, "When I Get Where I'm Going." When I get where I'm going on the far side of the sky, the first thing I'm going to do is spread my wings and fly. I'm going to land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, or I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. When I get to where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years. And I'll leave my heart wide open, and I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. I'm going to walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how much I've missed him every minute since he left, and then I'll hug his neck. So much pain and so much darkness in this world we stumble through. All these questions I can't answer. There's so much work to do. But when I get to where I'm going, I'll see my Maker's face, and I'll stand forever in his light and see his amazing grace. When I get to where I'm going, when I get to where I'm going, there will be only happy tears. I will love and have no fear when I get to where I'm going. Although we are not yet where Alice is, I think there's a lot of words of wisdom for us in this song. For we do not need to wait to get to our final resting place, to experience a life without sin or struggle, without darkness to stumble through. We can stand right now in God's light and experience God's truly amazing grace. We don't have to wait to get where we're going to understand the amazing love and majesty of God. Today, we give gratitude for the life of Alice Marie Rainey Osborne. And I want you to be grateful that you are among the people who lived in this time and in this place. You are one of the few of the billions on this earth who got to be in her life, and you got to love her. And let us give thanks to God. Amen.
Go rest high. Oh, how we cried the day you left us. We gathered round your grave to grieve. Wish I could see angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. So go rest high on that mountain, son, your work on earth is done. Go to heaven, shout love for the Father and the Son.
After we dismiss from this place, we will continue our remembrances as we commit Alice to the ground, to the earth, in the North Middletown Cemetery. But before we dismiss, let us pray together once again. Merciful God, we grieve deeply because we love fully. So I ask your blessing upon these people here today who have experienced a significant loss. Help turn their crying into dancing. Dry every tear from their eyes. Comfort them with your words of hope and with your presence upon them, so they know that they have not been abandoned, but you are accompanying them every step of this journey. Help them over the days, weeks, and months ahead to feel the tight grip of grief loosen ever so slightly as they adjust to this different rhythm of life without Alice in it. Let them know that you are their comforter, their care, and their provider. Let us also warm our hearts with the many good memories that you have given us of this very special lady. And let us, even in sorrow, continue in gratitude for the life of Alice Marie Rainey Osborne. For this, and in every circumstance, we do indeed give thanks to God. And we thank you also for Jesus Christ our Lord, who is our beginning and who is our end, the one who revealed to us that life eternal is stronger than the mortal death of our bodies. Amen.